Hello students, in this video we will discuss about group communication. The contents include indirect communication, group communication, programming model and implementation issues. Let us see in detail. Indirect communication. What is meant by an indirect communication? Suppose think that we have a sender and we have a receiver. So, this particular sending process wants to send a message to the receiver. If this process, that is the sending process, sends this message to the receiver directly, this is known as direct communication. But in the case of an indirect communication, there will be an intermediary acting between the sender and the receiver. So that the sender will send the message to this intermediary and from here the message will be delivered to the receiver. So, indirect communication means the two entities in a distributed system are communicating through an intermediary. There is no direct coupling between the communicating entities. So that indirect communication is often used in distributed system where a change is anticipated. That means whenever the system is in a need to change or update or replicate any of the participants. Any of the participants means any of the senders or any of the receivers. If the system is using indirect communication, it will be more easy to do that because there is no direct connection between the sender and the receiver. Now, let us discuss what is meant by a group communication. Group communication is considered as an example of indirect communication. And in the case of a group communication, there will be a sender and this will offer a service where message is sent to a group and then this message is delivered to all members of the group. That means the sender will send the message to an intermediary group and from that group it will be delivered to all members of the group. The sender is not aware about the identities of the receiver in the case of a group communication. And we can consider that the group communication as a representation over multicast communication. It represents an abstraction over multicast communication. Now let us see why this group communication is an important building block for many of the distributed system. Because it has some key areas of application like reliable dissemination of information to potentially large number of clients. And the second one, support for collaborative application like multi-user games and all. And it also support for a range of fault tolerance strategies and support for monitoring and management. Now let us discuss about the programming model of a group communication. We already stated that in the case of a group communication, the sender will be sending the message to a particular group and the group will deliver it to all members of the group. So we can say that the central concept of a group communication is a group with associated group membership so that any processes can join or leave the group. So we can consider this group communication as a multicast communication. That means we are implementing the group communication using a multicast communication so that the message is sent to all members of the group by a single operation. Single operation means see this figure. This is the figure for multicast. Here we have a sender. The node represented using red color is the sender. So this sender is sending a message to some other processes in a particular group. So that in the case of a multicast communication, it will be sent to a group interface and from here it will be delivered to all the members of the group. This is why this is called multicast communication. And this figure depicts unicast communication where there will be one sender. This is the sender and the sender will send the message to this particular receiver. This is the receiver. If the sender wants to send a message to this process, it has to establish an individual connection with this particular process. And in the case of a broadcast, the sender can send the message to all the processes irrespective of the groups. But in the case of a multicast, the sender can send to a particular group and it will be delivered to all members of the group. So we stated that group communication is using multicast operation to send a message, so that it needs only one multicast operation. It needs only a single multicast operation to send the message to many members of a particular group. And it does not need to issue multiple send operations to individual process. See, this is the sender, and if it want to send a message to a particular members of a group, it can multicast the message. There is no need to send directly, that is from this node to here or this node to here. It is not necessary. It can send to a group interface. By this, we can achieve a great utilization of bandwidth as well as the total time. Total time taken to deliver the messages to all destination can also be minimized. Now let us see what is meant by a process groups and an object group. We started with group communication discussion, and we stated that a group is the central concept of a group communication. So a process group is nothing but the communicating entities in that group will be processes. And the other one is the object group. In this particular group, the communicating entities are objects. Objects means it is normally instances of the same class. But process groups are considered as a low level abstraction, whereas object groups are some higher level of abstraction. And object group also supports data marshalling, whereas the process groups does not support data marshalling for long byte data. Now let us see what is meant by a closed group as well as an open group. So this figure depicts a closed group. Closed group means this is that particular group, and we have three processes, 1, 2 and three processes in this group. Only the members of this particular group can communicate with each other. Think that if this process wants to send a message, first it has to deliver that message to itself, then have to deliver it to other processes in the group. No processes outside this particular group can enter or send any message to the processes inside the group. That is why it is called a closed group. Now observe in the case of an open group. We have 1, 2 and 3 processes inside this group. These processes can communicate with each other, as well as any process outside the group can also send a message to the members of this particular group. So this group is considered as an open group. Then next category is overlapping and non-overlapping groups. Overlapping groups means a process or an object can be a member of multiple groups. That means it can be a member of more than one group. But a non-overlapping group means the membership does not overlap. That means any process or object which belong to one group cannot be a member of the other group. That is, at most one group it can exist. That's all about group communication and various process groups and objects group. Thank you.